I'm Jimmy Conrad alongside with Heath Pierce. We're breaking down all the games here, CONCACAF World Cup qualifying match day one. Heath, let's talk a little Mexico versus Jamaica. Jamaica had to come with somewhat of a C team. This was kind of sad for them because if they had had everyone available, Mikel Antonio in particular, who's red hot with West Ham in the Premier League, going to Azteca, where they had that one game ban where they couldn't have fans, makes Azteca less intimidating by about 1,000. And they still hung with Mexico with their C team. It was 1-1 at one point. And then Henry Martin comes on as a super sub and scores in the 89th minute to save face for the Mexicans. And not necessarily Tata Martino's job, because we saw it in the Gold Cup where they outshot Trinidad and Tobago, 75-1, and it was a 0-0 draw. It felt very similar to that, but they end up getting all 3 points. And that's what hurts me a little bit more from a United States perspective, because with Canada drawing, and if Mexico had drawn, we would have missed out on a big opportunity to kind of take an early lead on the table. And now Mexico, our biggest rivals, have it. Talk to me about that game.
Yeah, this game was what I expected. Mexico at home, they played a mix of their Olympic squad and their A team. So it's kind of a mix of their A and B team, more of like a mix of their A and their young team, I guess you could say. They didn't look great, but they definitely, if they ended up drawing, it would have been just a recap of like squandered chances. Finish your chances, you beat Jamaica. Jamaica had a lot of fight, but if you look for long periods, they would just drop deeper and deeper until it was like a 5-back line, and then they'd see two more drop into it and seven, and they're now they're in their box. They actually, Mexico scored their first, if I remember correctly, on a hit outside the box, just because there weren't players stepping out. But yeah, Jamaica looked out of their depth,
of course,
but it could have been huge. It could have been a huge opportunity. Like you said, we saw Canada motivated by this depleted roster in the Gold Cup on this run of just this grit and fight. That's easier to do in tournament play, right? You build on this, nothing to lose type of mentality. But when you come into this, these circumstances just a few days ago or like a week ago, you thought you were going to have your A team. And then you were like, okay, we got a few guys. And you're like, now we have less than a few guys. And now you're on your C team. It's a really hard thing to overcome. And I think that they put up a valiant effort. Mexico, though, this is the difference, right? When I think back at the standards we should be holding our U.S. players I look at Mexico. Mexico don't get a break between generations in terms of expectations. And they're forced to deliver. It's 1-1 late in the game. Henry Martin gets subbed in. He's competing for a starting spot against Funes Mori. Both of them are competing for a starting spot against Jimenez, who didn't come in because of the restrictions right now, and comes up with a banger. Obviously, Blake gets a hand on it, could have potentially been saved, but still comes up in big moments. And I think Mexico have this bit of like, we believe mentality late in games where somebody's going to create magic. We had that with Weston McKennie in the Nations League. We had that at times in the Gold Cup where it was sort of like, even if we're not playing well, we'll find a way to win. That's what I thought was missing against El Salvador. But Mexico came up with that, right? They had plenty of chances. They had a few chances squandered. They should have definitely won that game. They controlled it from start to finish. And in the end, they won, right? And so you can look at it and you go, oh, we're critical because they had a lot of sitters. They should have, or at least a few sitters that were clear-cut chances. They should have finished. They didn't. Ended up getting the goal. And now you look at Mexico. And by the way, Tata Martino's not traveling for the Panama and Costa Rica games because he has an eye issue.
We'll see if they play better because of that. Sometimes when the right-hand man takes over, the people relax a little bit.
That's what the jokes are, that people are saying, well, he clearly can't see the right team to put on the field. Twitter's undefeated.
It is undefeated.
It was a semi-quality match from Mexico, but a professional performance in the fact that they, things to work on, but they got the result.
I do want to, and if there's any Mexican fans listening or watching on the YouTubes, I kind of started to liken them to Arsenal fans in some ways. Like, it doesn't go, and it's just like the manager has to get out, Martino out. I'm like, listen, how we lost to the U.S. twice, in two big finals. It's because we know we're better on set pieces. That was really the fine margins. We're just better on set pieces. In the run of play, we could argue that Mexico were better in both finals. Now, in this particular game against Jamaica, 27 shots, 75% possession, 7 shots on goal. Jamaica only had 1 shot on goal and they scored it. And I don't know what else you want Tata Martino to do. Like, if I'm a coach and my team has outshot the other team 27-1, I've got 75% possession. Yo, I'm doing my job. I'm absolutely doing my job. Maybe I didn't pick the right players who didn't have the finishing touch at that particular moment. And then defensively, maybe they got a little lax. But Tata Martino can't go out there and mark people on set pieces or close the ball down. Like, he's putting those guys. I'm sure they can make other choices, the guys that would do it, blah, 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 blah. But 27 shots, 75% possession, complete control of the game. I don't know what else you want from the guy, to be honest. I mean, if the players can't make the plays, I just don't know if that's on Tata Martino. I think that, again, the players need to take some responsibility for how they're performing. And we saw it in the Gold Cup as well. And Mexico's somewhat notorious for that, right? Where they're always in complete control and they just lack that little thing to get them over the hump, which is why they've lost in the round of 16 in the last five World Cups. You know, there's just that one thing that they can't take that next step. And not to say that was on evidence today in the Jamaica game, but I just kind of wanted to, like, just Mexican fans need to calm down. Tata Martino is a fantastic manager. And I'm jealous that you have him. I mean, obviously played with Greg. I'm a big Greg Berhalter fan, but Tata Martino is the goods, man. So you just got to stick with him.
So their next two games, I believe, are away to Costa Rica and Panama, which won't be easy games. And again, you look at it and you go, okay, mm-hmm. He played a mix of primarily your Olympicos roster. Not primarily, but a good mix of those. And you come out of it going, hey, we got the win 2-1. I trusted this lineup. Mm-hmm. We took a risk on this. It wasn't looking great. You know, there was probably going to be some Tata outs. There probably was a lot of Tata outs in the second half when it was 1-1 or in the closing minutes. They get the goal that they want, and then they look back at it as a professional performance. We knew we'd get it out, blah, blah, blah. A number of things you can work on. But the most important thing is they're at home. No fans at the stadium, and they get the result heading into their next two.
That's it. At the end of the day, they got the 3 points. The only team to do so far out of the 8 teams that are in the octagonal.